Now the star-bellied sneeches have bellies with stars. The plain-bellied sneeches have none upon theirs. So, those stars weren't so big, they were really so small. You might think such a thing wouldn't matter at all. But because they had stars, all the star-bellied sneeches would brag.
They're the best kind of sneeches on the beach.
With their snoots in the air, they would sniff and they'd snort.
We won't have nothing to do with the plain-bellied sort.
And whenever they met some, when they were out walking, they'd hike right on past them without even talking. When the star-bellied children went out to play ball, could a plain belly get in the game? Not at all. You only could play if your belly had stars, and the plain belly children had none upon ours. When the star belly sneeches had frankfurter roasts or picnics or parties or marshmallow toasts, they never invited the plain-bellied sneeches. They left them out cold in the dark of the beaches. They kept them away, never let them come near. And that's how they treated them, year after year. Then, one day, it seems, while the plain-bellied sneeches were moping and doping alone on the beaches, just sitting there wishing their bellies had stars, a stranger zipped up in the strangest of cars. My friends, he announced in a voice clear and keen.
My name is Sylvester McMonkey McBean.
And I've heard of your troubles. I've heard you're unhappy. But I can fix that.
I'm a fix-all champion.
I've come here to help you. I have what you need. My prices are low, and I work at great speed. And my work is 100% guaranteed. Then quickly, Sylvester McMonkey McBean put together a very peculiar machine. And he said, "You want stars like the star-bellied sneech? My friends, you can have them for $3 each."
This baby can lend me a half a dozen.
So they clambered inside, and the big machine roared. It clunked, and it bumped, and it jerked, and it burped. And it bopped them about, but the thing really worked. When the plain-bellied sneeches topped out, they had stars. They actually did. They had stars upon ours. Then they yelled at the ones who had stars at the start.
Who's that good kid? You can't tell us the power. Well, not. Just all say no. New York Smellies. And now we can go to your favorite parties.
Good dream.
We're all the ones who had stars at the first.
We're still the best peaches in there to work.
But now, how in the world will we know they all frown? If which kind is what, or the other way around? Then up came McBean with a very sly wink. And he said, things are not quite as bad as you think. So you don't know who's who? That's perfectly true. But come with me, friends. Do you know what I'll do? I'll make you again the best sneeches on the beaches. And all it will cost you is $10 beaches. Belly stars are no longer in style, said McBean. What you need is a trip through my star off machine. This wondrous contraption will take off your stars, so you won't look like sneeches who have them on theirs. And that handy machine, working very precisely, remove all the stars from their tummies quite nicely. Then, with the snoots in the air, they paraded about, and they opened their beaks and they let out a shout. We know who's who. There isn't a doubt. The best kind of sneeches are the sneeches without. Then, of course, those with stars all got frightfully mad. To be wearing a star now was frightfully bad. Then, of course, old Sylvester McMonkey McBean invited them to his star-off machine. Then, of course, from then on, you probably guessed, things really got into a horrible mess. All the rest of that day, on those wild, screaming H's, the fix-up chappy kept fixing up sneeches. Off again, on again, in again, out again, through the machines they raced around and about again, changing their stars every minute or two. They kept paying money. They kept running through until neither the plane nor the star bellies knew whether this one was that one, or that one was this one, or which one was what one, or what one was who. Then, when every last cent of their money was spent, the fix-up chappy packed up and he went. And he laughed as he drove his car up the beach.
So he wasn't wearing the candy to sneech.
But McBean was quite wrong, I'm quite happy to say, that the sneeches got really quite smart on that day. The day they decided that sneeches are sneeches, and no kind of sneech is the best